Hello, I welcome you to this video. In this video, I'll be showing you how to render your Revit project with Revit. This time around, you are going to render only with Revit without any add-on or without any third-party software. So the first thing you are going to do is you are going to go to any of the floor plan. Any of the floor plan here will be okay. Anyone will be all right. So you are going to go to view. If you go to view, you will see 3D here. You will see a drop down. Click on the drop down and select camera. It now depends on where you want to view your 3D from. Let's say I want to view it from the right hand side corner. I'm going to go a little bit far from the building and place my camera. Then I will now move the camera target towards the building and position it very well before I click. And here is the 3D. You can stretch this side, you can stretch it out, and you can make it color. I want to make it color so that I'll be able to appreciate it. Then if you want to position it properly, you can still use your shift and middle mouse button to turn it. Then you can be turning it and positioning it properly. Try and position it properly, because the position matters a lot. It improves the aesthetic of the building. Okay, let's say this is how I want it to be positioned. Alright, then the next thing you will do is you are going to make this crop size bigger, because the bigger it is, the more qualitative your rendering will be and the more time it will take to render. And I want to believe your client need quality job, so you have to give him that quality. So you are going to make this crop size bigger. And how you are going to make it bigger is this: you go to size crop, then you are going to lock this scale so that as you are increasing the width, the height is also increasing. It's not going to tamper with the proportion. Let's say I want to increase the width to something like 300, and if I hit apply now, the height is automatically updated, and click OK. You can see it's bigger now. If I render this one now, the resolution of this one is going to be better than if I had rendered the first one without increasing the crop size. Okay. The larger the crop size, the better the output. Okay, the next thing you will do is you will go to see show rendering dialog. Click on it, and this dialog box is going to come up. Initially, when you are starting, when you are testing, let it be on draft, because draft will not take time, and it will be able to show you preview of how your rendering is going to be. Then when you are done rendering, When you are done testing and you are sure that the materials are okay, before you change it to something like best, high, or medium, something like I use these things for high quality rendering, high and best. Medium and draft are for both testing. When I test with draft small, after small time, I take it to medium. Then when I'm okay with the medium, I can now go to high and best. That is the sense. So that you don't end up wasting time on best. And at the end, you see that something has to be adjusted. You would have wasted your time for nothing. Then I always take it to printer when I'm doing my own rendering. I take it to printer. Then when it is a final rendering, you are going to take it to something like, depends on the strength of your system, to take it to something like 300 dpi or 600. Okay, now if I change the size to 300 dpi now, you will notice something here. If I change the size to 300 dpi, you will see that the pixel size has changed to 3543 pixels by 3172 pixels. And if I change it to 600 dpi, you will see that it's now larger. And the quality of this one is going to be better than any of this one. But it depends on the strength of your computer. If your computer is not very strong, then it's going to take a very long time before it finishes rendering. Okay. Let me take it back to 150 megapixel, to 150 dpi, sorry. Let me take it to 150 dpi, and the uncompressed size is 10.7 MB, and this is on draft. We want to make use of that. And sun setting, let me take it to something like sun from top right and click OK. Let me disable this. Then let me render this and see what it's going to give me. It has started rendering now, and until it's done, before I'll be able to work any other thing as far as Revit is concerned, I will not be able to do anything in Revit now until the rendering is completed. So when the rendering is completed, I'm going to come back. Okay, the rendering is completed. You can see it here, the rendering is completed. It's not too bad. Something is bad here. This step is not where the door has shifted. Okay, I'm going to work on that. And the glass color is not what I want it to be. I'm going to update that. I'm going to update the glass color, that is the material. I will also update the mullion. Here, this is where you are going to see some materials that needs attention. So I'm going to be working on some of these materials. Okay. And if you want to save this image now, you'll be able to save it here. Save to project. If I save to project, it's going to be on this Revit. Then if I hit export, is going to save it on my computer. Let me select a folder I want to save it in, Revit tutorial. I'm going to give it a name. Okay. 3D view 3, it's not bad. Then here you are going to select either PNG or JPEG or TIFF. TIFF and PNG work similar because here you'll be able to work on the 3D in Photoshop or other software like PowerPoint. You will be able to remove because PNG will not have background. For instance, if you don't like the background of what you have here, you want to replace it with another sky, then it is advisable you save it as PNG so that you will be able to place another interesting background on it in Photoshop or PowerPoint. You can also do it in CorelDRAW. You can do it in Microsoft Word, Microsoft Office, all those software that can edit pictures and images. So I'm going to save it as PNG now. I don't recommend that you save it as JPEG here now if you want to edit it, unless you don't want to edit it. That's when you are going to save it with JPEG. But if you still have interest on editing it, then it's better you save it with either PNG or TIFF. T-I-F-F. It's not TIFF as in criminal. Okay, so I'm going to save it as a PNG now. PNG and hit save. Okay, that is done. We have saved it now. In the next video, we'll see how we can work on these materials. We'll see how we can work on the materials before we produce our final rendering. All right. Thank you for watching this video and see you in the next video. Bye.